Tax cuts may soon be back on the agenda for Congress and the White House. Sometime next month, the House and Senate are likely to hold votes on making the previous historic GOP tax cuts, which were only set to last for 10 years, permanent.
Next is tax cut part two. And that is around April 15th, tax day. There will be a vote, maybe a series of votes, to make all of the individual tax cuts permanent. Because of the budget rules, where we did a budget reconciliation, takes 51 votes in the Senate, you could only cut taxes for 10 years.
So far, tax cuts part two have been little more than a rumor on Capitol Hill. But now it appears GOP leaders likely are on board, says Grover Norquist, president of Americans for Tax Reform. If so, it would amount to a permanent pay increase for most American families, but could also give the GOP a wedge issue to use against the Democrats come this fall.
And we're going to have a vote around April 15th, and one of two things happen. The Democrats vote for it, and it passes, and we make those tax cuts permanent for everybody. Win-win. Or the Democrats vote no, and we have a chance for a month around that period to say, here's the tax cut the Republicans delivered. We want to make it permanent. The Democrats voted against it, and then they voted against making it permanent. So they've now voted twice against your tax cut.
And would have voted twice not to give families the equivalent of pay raises, says Norquist. Meanwhile, Norquist says the Trump administration could announce soon a plan to index capital gains for inflation, essentially an executive order-like action that would subtract the effect of inflation when calculating the value of an asset when it is sold for tax purposes.
There will likely be a regulatory definitional change from the IRS and the Treasury Department that will end the taxation of inflation on capital gains. So your house, land, a stock you own, hold it for 20, 30, 50 years, much of the capital gain that is taxed on capital gains taxes is actually inflation. It's amazing we haven't done this before, but Larry Kudlow, the new head of economic policy at the White House, is in favor of this, and I believe you'll see it in the next 3 months.
Norquist says that by accounting for inflation, the capital gains tax could be cut in half on average. So one way or another, the GOP hopes American families may see more money in their wallets as a result of tax changes this spring. John Hines, One America News, Washington.
We can use your help. Call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call today,